Hello, welcome to a new Reiki ASMR video. Today's video is going to help you deal with change, to help you de-stress, to help you soothe your nervous system as you step into a new chapter in your life. So make sure you're sitting somewhere comfortably. Plant your feet firmly down onto the floor, or if you're laying down, become aware of the back of your body, laying onto your mattress or on the floor. And then imagine roots shooting down from the soles of your feet or from your back body, shooting all the way down into the earth. And your roots are shooting down the floor, through the foundation of the house that you're in or the building that you're in, and very deep down into the earth. Allow your roots to shoot even further down, deep into the core of Mother Earth. And the deeper your roots grow, the more grounded you feel. Allow any anxiety to flow down the body through your roots. We're going to start off our session with a bit of cleansing, as usual. We're going to use a couple of dried leaves of sage. Also, if you can hear construction noise in the background, that's because my neighbors are constructing. So apologies for that. If you have any intentions for today's session, then you can state them now in your head. Take a deep breath in, smell the sage, and exhale out. Deep breath in through your nose. Last one, inhale in, and exhale out. Just going to move the sage through your aura field. As usual, throughout the session, stay connected to your roots. So today's session is all about change. How to cope with change, how to cope with a chapter ending and a new one starting. So we'll focus on creating stability in the body and in your energetic field. So that you are ready to handle whatever's coming your way. I will keep the sage burning and just pop it right next to you here. So, we have a few crystals that we're going to work with today that I'm just going to place all around you. We have 5 in total. I'm going to start with the biggest one, which is hematite. This is a super grounding stone. It's very heavy as well. Has quite a bit of weight to it. Let's see if I can focus on it. So it has a metallic sheen. And as I said, this one is super grounding. I like to hold onto this stone when I'm feeling anxious. It's kind of like a weighted blanket for your soul, for your aura. So this is our first grounding crystal. I'm going to place this next to you. If you want to, you can hold on to it. And just imagine it kind of rooting you down, anchoring you down, even deeper into the earth. Then we have this really beautiful moss agate, which I think is going to be hard to show on camera, but it has a sort of moss-like formation inside. I think you can see here the tip showing through. It's absolutely stunning. But moss agate is all about new beginnings. It's the stone of new beginnings. So as change happens, obviously it makes way for new things to come through. So we're going to use this beautiful moss agate to represent that. And this as well is quite a grounding stone, maybe not as grounding as the hematite. Place this one next to you as well. Then we have black onyx with, I think, a band of white onyx in there, I'm not sure. Again, super grounding. And I like that this one is kind of egg-shaped. You can imagine being inside of this little onyx egg, and you're just about to crack out of it. You're just in that period of uncomfortable transformation where you have outgrown the situation that you're in, or maybe you don't even want to leave the situation that you're in, but something outside of yourself, something in your environment is pushing you out. So you can imagine this transition period to be like cracking out of your egg. It's a necessary phase in life. Definitely not the most comfortable. But you can make it more comfortable by stopping to resist it. Allowing it to be, to happen, to unfold. So just tune into the energy of the onyx. Again, a very grounding stone, crystal. And all the stones that I've shown so far are really good at absorbing negative energies. So if there's anything in particular that you want to let go of, you can hand it over to the crystals. Placing this one next to you as well. Then we have bloodstone, which doesn't really look like blood at all. As this is a type of jasper, I believe. See if I can get it to focus. It has different colors, kind of like brownish, rusty red colors, some greenish blue here on the side. This is a very purifying crystal. It is connected to your blood, as the name of the crystal is bloodstone. But it's also really good to work on energy flow. So I kind kind of helps to have a better energy flow throughout your body. So it helps dislodge any energy blocks, allowing your energetic field to go back to its homeostasis, its place of rest where it likes to be, the place where it functions optimally. So just connecting here with the bloodstone. Notice if you feel pressure in any of your energy centers, any of your chakras. And if you do, allow any of that tension to be sent to this bloodstone. Relax the muscles around your energy centers. Sometimes we feel fear in our hips. Sometimes we feel it in our solar plexus, in our heart, in our throat, in our gut. So wherever you feel it in your body, try to soften yourself around it. Don't try to squash it or don't try to get rid of it. Just soften around the feeling. And it will take care of itself. Okay. So I put that one next to you. Getting a little field here already for your energy flow through your aura. How are you feeling? Okay. The last crystal that I'm going to hand over to you is Lapetta Light. I believe it is. I'm not 100% sure. I've had this one for years. And I used to buy crystals just because I thought they were pretty. I didn't really look into their meaning or healing properties or anything like that. But I think this is a little bit of light. And there's actually a little piece of mica, which I'm not sure I'll be able to catch because the light needs to hit it just right. Let's see if I can get it. Yeah, you're just gonna have to believe me, there's a little piece of mica in there. Lapetta Light is a very comforting stone. So after all of the grounding and the cleansing that we've done with the other crystals, we're going to calm your nervous system. Imagine this as a balm for your energy field around you. Lapetta Light is still very cleansing, still very grounding, but it has that sense of warmth to it, that sense of calming and comfort. This is probably the ultimate weighted blanket. It's not as heavy as the hematite, but it has that cozy feeling to it, whereas the hematite is a little bit colder and feeling. So I'm just working the Lapetta Light through your aura field. You can imagine your nervous system calming down, going from your spinal cord out to the periphery of your body. So you can imagine warm water being poured down the top of your head, all the way through your spinal cord, and diffusing out into the rest of your body, giving a very comforting and warming sensation. Your nerves are soothed. They feel balmy and relaxed. So the Lapetta Light is going to be placed next to you as well, along with the other crystals. At any time, you can tune into those crystals if you feel like it. Next up, I have my kyanite blade, which I'm going to use to separate the cords in your energy field so that we can pluck out any residual energies that are troubling you. Alright, so I'm just gliding the kyanite blade through your aura. Now you can imagine this feeling like a thumb running over a muscle. So it's just kind of separating the muscle fibers in your aura, or energetic fibers. And with it, it's infusing the healing energy of the kyanite. So now that all your strands are combed through and separated, it's going to be much easier now to pluck out the energies that don't belong anymore. And we can pluck out your anxiety as well, your anxious thoughts, those thoughts that keep looping on repeat, thoughts that are not serving you anymore, that are just causing you more anxiety. We're just going to pluck them out to give your nervous system a break so that you can arrive back in the present moment, because your anxious thoughts are keeping you from being present. And the best way to deal with change, to allow things to unfold as they are, being aware of them in the present moment so that you can cope with them as they come up. So, today I thought of doing something slightly different. I have two chopsticks, and we're going to pluck out your anxieties, your stress, with these chopsticks. I really love the sound of wood on wood. I'm not the best at chopsticks, so there we go. So I'm just going to pluck and just put it off to the side. So let go. 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 selenite wand. I'm going to channel pure love, pure healing light, and infuse your aura with it. So all the anxieties that we just plucked out, we're going to fill those cavities with love and light. Divine love, divine light, divine trust in the timing of things, divine trust that you are guided on the right path. Trust that everything will work out as it should in time. You may not be able to see how this will make sense, how it'll fit together, but it will. You just have to be patient and trust. You're held and you're safe. So combing through aura with the selenite wand. Allowing all the gaps to be filled up. There's anything that you want to let go of. Imagine it traveling down the body, through the soles of your feet, into the earth. If there's anything that you need help with, you can ask your spirit guide. Ask them for assurance, for guidance. You don't have to do it alone. And maybe their message will come in the form of another person. Maybe you'll have a conversation with someone and they'll mention something that provides an answer for you. Or maybe an opportunity will come your way that will help you figure things out. You don't have to go through it alone. You're held and you're safe. Fluffing up your aura right now to give it some bounce so that you have a little bit of extra capacity around you, so that anything that comes your way has something or somewhere to land. This extra fluffing of the aura also makes sure that anything that is not meant for you will bounce right back. It won't stick, it won't stay. Just like water off a duck's back, it'll roll right off you. Okay. Let's have it feel. Your nervous system feels a lot more soothed and calm and grounded. Your thoughts are quieter. more spacious. I think you're ready. I hope you enjoyed today's session. I'm really sorry about the background noise.